Welcome to Virginia Union University's weekly chapel services. Our university pastor is the Reverend Angelo V. Chatman. Welcome to these hallowed grounds and dear old walls inside the historic Coburn Hall within the Reverend Dr. Alex Bledsoe James Memorial Chapel. Welcome.
Come on, everybody, clap your hands a little bit. We came to lift up the name of the Lord. Let the world know that every praise is to our God. Come on, let's say it one good time. Here we go. Come on, VUU, let's do it. Every praise.
Every praise is to our God.
Every word of worship.
Every word of worship.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise.
To our God.
Sing hallelujah.
Sing hallelujah.
To our God.
To our God.
Woo.
Glory, hallelujah. To our God.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise.
To our God.
To our God.
Come on, let's take it up.
Every praise.
To our God.
To our God.
Every word of worship.
Every word of worship.
Whoa. Every praise.
To our God.
Glory.
Glory, hallelujah.
Whoa.
To our God.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise. It's to our God. Come on.
To our God.
Come on, let's go up one more time.
Every praise.
To our God.
Every word of worship.
Whoa. Come on, give it to me in harmony.
Sing hallelujah. Sing hallelujah.
To our God.
To our God.
Glory.
Glory, hallelujah. It's to our God.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise.
It's to our God.
It's to our God.
Come on, clap your hands, all you people.
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
Come on, give it to me in harmony. God, my Savior.
God, my Savior.
God, my healer.
God, my healer.
God, my deliverer. Come on.
God, my
deliverer. Yes, he is.
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 Yes, he is. Every praise, come on. Every praise.
Every praise.
Come on, say every praise. Every praise.
Every praise.
Every praise. To our God. Clap your hands, come on. Whoa.
Worship.
God bless you.
Greetings, Virginia Union University Panthers. I am the Reverend Dr. Marquita Carmichael, and I am excited to come and to share our last chapel service of the 2020-2021 academic school year. On behalf of our university pastor, the Reverend Angelo V. Chatman, the Dean of the School of Theology, the Reverend Dr. Gregory M. Howard, our illustrious president, Dr. Hakeem J. Lucas, and his cabinet, and all of the students all across this campus. The message today is going to be a short message. It is found in the book of Numbers in the Christian sacred text. The book of Numbers, chapter 6, verses 22 through 26. And here we find these words: May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. And may the very light of the Lord's countenance be lifted upon you, and may it give you peace. Let us pray. Wise, everlasting, and eternal God, for these tender moments that you have given to us to share, help us to glean from this passage what you would have each of us to know while we are yet still on this incredible journey of life. Thank you for the great opportunity that you have bestowed upon each of us, that we might gather in this space virtually together, that we might love one another, and that we might seek to continue to do your will in your way in the world. Thank you. Bless now the words of my mouth and allow the meditations of my heart to be acceptable in your sight. O Lord, I declare that you alone are my strength and you alone are my redeemer. Amen. Beloved, in the very basic sense, the book of Numbers is so called because of the two occasions the people of God were counted, first at Mount Sinai and the second on the plains of Moab. We have come to understand that these children of Israel were a nomadic people. They were travelers on the journey from a life in captivity on their way to becoming a nation. Numbers begins where Exodus leaves off and covers a span of about 39 years. This book is designed to train the Israelites in the laws and ceremonies of its religion, life, and culture. Now, beloved, Numbers contains the instructions for a life of service and walking in the ways of God. This passage of scripture found in this book of Numbers, chapter 6, verses 22 through 26, is called the Aaronic blessing, or the blessing of the priest. Moses received these words specifically for the priest to pronounce over the lives of the Israelites as a blessing. Often it is prayed as a benediction, a blessing over the people of God as they prepare to leave worship, to live lives all week long consecrated to God and in service to God. When we leave the chapel, when we leave the house of God, a blessing is offered, a blessing is received, and very often we hear these words: May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face to shine upon you and to be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. This passage of scripture is directed to a people who are on a journey of a lifetime. This is a covering for a people who are on the move. They are not stagnant. They're preparing to move forward. This text, this passage, as it were, is for a people who are on their way into their destiny. They were leaving somewhere significant and heading somewhere set aside specifically for them. These people, these children of Israel, they were walking in one way, and they were now trading in that way for their own path of wanderings for the ways of God. These people were on a journey of a lifetime, and they were not to leave the place of worship, not to leave the presence of the priest without an essential component for their next leg of the journey. They were heading out of the wilderness and into the promised land, but they were not to leave without the full blessing of God. In all of their planning, all of their preparations, all of their packing, they are not to leave. They are not to break camp. They are not to go any way, my grandmother would say, another further without the blessing of the priest. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. And may the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. These are the words of a blessing often bestowed upon hopeful travelers, those going on a journey of their lifetime, not unlike those that you have come along this journey with from your freshman year to now, or for your first graduate year until now. This blessing is set aside for you who are launching out into the depths of life with anticipation and some with even greater expectations. The blessing is not withheld tonight for those of you embarking on a quest in life and for that oftentimes begins with hope and sometimes even fear. Many who have matriculated through these hallowed grounds and these dear old walls, they have come through this place as worshipers, and beloved, they have come as students, and now some are elders, and they are lifted up and they are buoyed upon the words that speak both to their present and to their future. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. And may the very Lord God, in God's own fullness, lift up the countenance of his blessing upon you, and may it give you peace. There's a word today for those who are on a journey of a lifetime. There's a word for those of you that are preparing to leave where you have been for perhaps the unknown of where you might be going. Your journey may be a spiritual one that lifts you from the level of mere understanding your faith to now knowing your mission and your assignment, even into a deeper revelation of truths that you never thought you would embrace. Another may be on a physical journey, causing you to leave what is familiar for parts unknown. You may be called and you might feel a tug to move physically from one place of employment, one job to another. You may be called to leave the comforts of home and of family that you love for another city, another country, another county perhaps. But beloved, this message is for those that are graduating from one degree of life to another, from one level of responsibility to another, from one position of prominence to one of relaxation and ease. Perhaps this is a message for someone on the journey through the stages of grief, stages of release or recovery of relationships. It is today a message certainly for those who are in fact and indeed on the journey of a lifetime. Your being here in this virtual space is witness that you are on this journey with us of a lifetime, because to complete the quest, to complete the journey, will most certainly require your lifetime. The Lebanese poet, artist, and author Khalil Gibran embarked upon the journey of a lifetime as a young boy who immigrated to America with his mother, and he came to the attention of his school teachers because of his artistic renderings. His name, as would be called Gibran Khalil Gibran's masterpiece work entitled The Prophet, begins somewhere in the middle of his own life's journey. The story begins of the prophet we are introduced to one of the main characters who is named Al-Mustafa, the prophet, who had somehow taken a journey by ship and found himself in a place called Orphalese. We are not privy, my friends, initially as to why he was there. We don't know how he found himself there. We do not know immediately what his task, his goal, or his assignment was. We, the gentle readers, must enter into his journey where the author grants us access. We find that the prophet, sitting atop a hill, looking out onto the horizon, searching for what he calls his vessel to return and ferry him back home to the place of his origin. We do not know why he was in Orphalese. We lack the information as to know how he came to be in the midst of these people or why his journey crossed paths with these particular ones at that appointed time. All we know is that he was there in Orphalese and he was on a hill waiting. Beloved, on a particular day, after looking, waiting, watching, and longing, Al-Mustafa sees his vessel out on the horizon. On the horizon, at the place where one's eyes seem to cause a meeting between the heavens and the earth, Al-Mustafa sees his ship coming in. For 12 long years, he had hoped for such a sight. For 12 long years, he believed his ship would arrive. So for 144 months, he searched and he waited. Now, as he prepared to leave that place, there was a tearing in his spirit. He had come to live and engage in the life of those of Orphalese. His presence was assumed and natural. His sojourn among them was one of truth, and his call was to be a revealer of these truths. And yet, on a certain day, his ship was sailing closer and closer, and his spirit hovered between the sadness of goodbyes and the anticipated joys awaiting him when he arrived at a place called home. Beloved, the people of Orphalese knew that the day would come that the prophet would have to leave. Perhaps he was so familiar among them that they secretly hoped that he would just remain. And yet, here they were preparing to live without him in their daily midst. They could all see that he was desirous of setting sail on another voyage, on another journey from another land called home. These wonderful people and their prophet Al-Mustafa came together in the way that beloveds do who really love one another on deep levels, but also know the truths that they will be parting come to light. The elders of Orphalese said to him, "Go not away from us. You have been our noontide in our twilight, and your youth has given us dreams to dream. You are no stranger to us. You are no guest. You are our son and dearly beloved." The elders came with words to bless the seafaring traveler. The priest and the priestess came and they entreated him not to go. They said, "You have walked among us, a spirit, and your shadow has been a light unto our faces." The people of Orphalese came to urge him to stay. They came with a type of yearning and desperation as if they needed to squeeze out the very last word of the beloved traveler, knowing that this parting may well be their last occasion to be together. They came to bless him with their presence and to receive from him a blessing that they could carry into their hearts and pass on to their children. The prophet was leaving. He was embarking upon a journey of his lifetime. He needed to begin. He had been waiting, and now the people gathered for a blessing. The seeress, Almitra, came forward and declared before all the people that while their love for him was great, it was their deepest desire that their love would not bind him, nor their own needs hold him. She was the first to seek him out and the first to believe in him, so she asserted some pastoral privilege with the prophet, and she said to Al-Mustafa, before you leave us, we ask that you speak to us and give us of your truths. In other words, we know you have to go, but before you do, won't you bless us? Won't you pause just long enough between I've got to go and right now? Won't you pause and speak to us and just bless us one more time? They came to bless him with their presence and to receive a blessing that they could carry on in their hearts and pass on to their children. So they asked him, what would he say to them about children? They needed to know what the prophet had to say about important things like love. What might he divulge about work and of joy and of sorrow? He was a traveler. He was moving on in his journey, and he was leaving a blessing upon the lives of the people that they promised to pass on to their children. Beloved, he was their prophet. He was like unto their priests. And the reader, the careful reader, comes to understand that the journey of a lifetime is not measured in miles, but rather in the lives one touches and the blessings one bestows upon the lives that they are privileged to touch and to share. Your journey, beloved, may begin like one told to go to a place that I will show you after you leave everything you know behind you. No roadmap except that the Lord has said, and faith. Your journey of a lifetime might not be a smooth road. It might not be filled with positive thinkers or positive speakers. It may be filled with naysayers. They may continue to laugh at those things that you do and that you say because they thought they knew you back when. Your journey may include some doubts and some fears. It might include more lefts than it does rights. There may be lies better left untold. Some bitterness better left behind. But remember, as you go, may the Lord bless you and keep you. Wherever you find yourself, wherever your journey of a lifetime takes you, may the Lord's face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. Remember, each of us is on the journey of our own lifetimes. Our paths may intersect from time to time if we are out in the mission field. We might meet on the front line of ministry or medicine. You might be our physicians that we come to, beloved. Remember, this is not a competition, but we are each fulfilling our calling, each fulfilling our part of the commandment. But may the Lord's Shekinah glory be upon you, and may that glory give you peace. Beloved, the story of the prophet's journey, not the whole of it, it's only a part. It encapsulates a moment, albeit a very tender moment, in the journey of his lifetime. And know this, that where you are right now and where you shall certainly find yourself on your own journey, it will take your entire lifetime to fulfill. And still, in this moment, as we reflect, and as you reflect upon your first days upon this campus, who you met, who your roommates were, who your cut buddies became, who your fraternity and lifelong sorority members and brothers and sisters are now. Remember the days that you walked across these hallowed grounds, getting from class to class. Remember the parties that were held in the gym. Remember the outdoor activities, but also remember that in this last year of your matriculation, something happened and something challenged you. It took you outside of the comforts of this campus. It caused you to do something you never thought you'd have to do. And it also made the gathering more challenging and more difficult, where you're not able to get together like you used to and put hugs around each other's necks and kisses on the cheek like you used to. Beloved, it's a part of your journey. But I encourage you that there are some people who would rather forget the journey. But for this moment, for this tender moment and for the next, some of these moments are life determining and life defining, some noteworthy, and some moments that you might rather forget. These special, special moments are only the moments of your lifetime. And I encourage you, I admonish you, whatever you do, wherever you go, don't leave without the blessing. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. And may the Lord lift up his own countenance upon you. And may it give you, gift you, peace. As you go, if you find yourself getting weary, lean back into the arms that have proven to be everlasting arms of the Lord who loves you. If you find yourself meeting sickness along the way, remind yourself that there really is a great physician who we can declare has never lost a patient. If trouble finds you as you travel on your way, if the case seems clearly against you, and even if they've got you dead to rights, there's still a lawyer who has never, never lost a case. And there's a judge who uses the mercy seat as his seat. There's one who uses mercy as his gavel. And the good news for us today is that while we can be regaled with the story of a significant pilgrim preparing to lead the great people of the mythical Orphalese, crafted from the mind of a significant pilgrim from Lebanon named Gibran Khalil Gibran, we can be reminded of the history of the Hebrew nation of Israel and the blessing reserved for the priests to bestow. We know that we are on the journey inward and outward and upward, but beloved, there is another journey. There's a journey of one who began before time and memorial. There is another, beloved, whose journey of a lifetime began with "let there be" and traveled all the way down through "it is finished." There is another whose journey of a lifetime will still continue to go on. Well, how long, Rev? His journey will continue until the answer to the question is answered. Well, somebody call for the question. Who are these in these radiant robes? How long, Reverend, until the answer comes? These are they who have come from the great journey of a lifetime. They've come through great tribulation, and they have washed their robes, and they've made them pure in the blood of the Lamb. Their journey of a lifetime has led them right here to the great coronation. They sing and they praise their God who brought them through. They are smiling and they are shouting, "Trouble's over." They're dancing in praise and in jubilation. Where Jesus is seated, his journey of a lifetime is going to culminate in the casting down of royal diadems. His journey of a lifetime, as well as ours, is going to end up in a place called home. The elders will be casting down their golden crowns around the glassy sea. We'll wrap up our journey of a lifetime with shouts of "Holy, holy, holy, Lord God Almighty." And on that great day, beloved, each of us will see exactly how significant each one of our journeys have been to the whole. We shall sing, as the songwriter says, we will put on our robes and tell the story of how we made it over. How our journey took us from being the first of our family to attend college, to be the first of our family to receive our degrees. What a day. What a day. When we can say that our journey took us from here and brought us there, took us from fear, to faith, took us from backsliding to baptism of the Holy Ghost. We will tell of our journey through the fire and through the flood, through the scandal and through the redemption. Beloved, we can sing together right now. I'm pressing on the upward way. New heights I'm gaining every day. Still praying as I onward bound. Lord, plant my feet on higher ground. Beloved, wherever you go from this place, wherever God plants your feet, may the Lord bless you and keep you. And may the Lord's face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. And may the very heart, the Spirit of the living God, lift up his countenance upon you, and may it give you peace. Beloved, as we leave this place, we will continue to see your faces in our mind's eyes. We'll remember you in our classes. We'll remember you fondly. The jokesters, as well as those who were the most serious. Those who slipped quite a bit, and those who stayed woke. We'll remember how you marched and rallied to get all of your students and classmates registered to be voters, and how you marched from this campus over to the voting polls. We shall never forget your tenacity. We shall never, ever, ever forget how good you made us, how much better we are because you are now alumni of this great university that we love so much. And as you prepare to leave this place, we don't know what God has in store for you, but may we offer you the blessing reserved for the priests, as a blessing upon the lives of the people. The blessing is a simple one. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and you and you. And may it give you, may it gift you peace. Amen. Amen.
Song is an affirmation that you can speak over your own life. It says, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Come on, y'all. Let's go. Here we go. Goodness.
Goodness and mercy shall follow me
all the days. Goodness, come on, say it.
Goodness and mercy shall follow me
all the days.
All of the days of my life.
Come on, say it again, everybody all over the world, say it.
Goodness and mercy shall follow me
all the days.
All of the days of my life.
That sounds good. Come on, goodness, say it.
Goodness and mercy shall follow me
all the days. Forever.
Forever.
And I will dwell. Come on.
I will dwell in the house of the Lord.
Forever.
Forever.
Come on, give me some harmony. Goodness and mercy. Sing out.
Goodness and mercy shall follow me
all the days.
All the days of my life.
That sounds good. Come on, goodness, here we go. All the days.
All the days of my life.
And I will dwell.
And I will dwell.
Come on, clap your hands, all ye people, real big.
Goodness and mercy follows me all of my day.
Come on, you say goodness, come on.
Goodness and mercy follows me.
Oh. Come on, say it one more time. Goodness, just like that. Come on.
Goodness and mercy follows me all of my days.
Come on, give it to me in harmony. Come on, real big.
Goodness and mercy follows me all of my days.
Goodness and mercy, sing out.
Goodness and mercy follows me all of my days. Come on, say. Goodness and mercy follows me
all of my days.
All of my days.
For the grace of God is on your life. And goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life. God bless you.
Thank you for joining us for another weekly chapel service. Students, please remember to click the link that you might receive your proper chapel credits. Thank you again for joining us. Join again next week.